Regular viewers of my channel will remember my previous two videos showing the complete construction process of the sub-building and dome assembly of the NASA-funded ATLAS telescope at the Sutherland Observatory. ATLAS is an acronym for Asteroid Terrestrial Impact Last Alert System. More details just now. Two crates were shipped to Sutherland in the meantime, one containing the telescope mount and the other the telescope itself. This video shows the crane lift of these two items. In preparation, during a quick trip to site a month before, Nick and I took the mount base plate out of the crate, which had to be epoxied and bolted onto the pier. Using a plumbed line, the center of rotation of the dome first had to be confirmed and an accurate north-south line drawn by marking its shadow exactly at solar noon. Note, there is no significance that the shims used to get the base plate perfectly level reminds of the all-seeing eye Illuminati emblem. A 4-ton truck crane was booked to do the lift on Wednesday, 10 November. The crane operator pleasantly surprised us by arriving 1 hour earlier than stipulated, apparently unheard for previous crane jobs in Sutherland, so we could get cracking by 7 a.m. We had John and Larry from ATLAS on a Zoom call to witness the entire process and were conveniently on hand when and where we had questions. Both the mount and the telescope tube were lifted into the dome without issues and we were done and dusted by 11 a.m. Something I thought was particularly convenient is that the crane had a remote control, so none of the usual hand signs were needed since the operator can be right there where the action is. The truck can even be started and switched off remotely. The ATLAS project was developed at the University of Hawaii with a $5 million funding from NASA. The first telescope became fully operational at the end of 2015 and the second in March 2017. The system currently consists of 2.5 meter or 20 inch telescopes located 160 kilometers apart at the Haleakala and Mauna Loa observatories respectively. In August 2018, the project obtained $3.8 million additional NASA funding to install two telescopes in the Southern Hemisphere, one to be hosted by the South African Astronomical Observatory and another destined for Chile. The ATLAS system thus combines a comparatively small telescope with a very powerful 110 megapixel CCD camera capable of detecting a match flame in New York viewed from San Francisco. Each telescope has the field of view of 15 times the diameter of the full moon, which automatically scans the whole sky several times every night looking for moving objects. ATLAS will be able to provide 1 day's warning for a 30 kiloton town killer, or a week's warning for a 5 megaton city killer, and 3 weeks for a 100 megaton county or province killer. In addition to searching for asteroids, ATLAS also finds dwarf planets, supernova explosions, and flashes of light that occur when a star is gobbled up by a supermassive black hole in a distant galaxy. So far, ATLAS discovered almost 700 near-Earth asteroids, 70 potentially hazardous asteroids, 65 comets, and nearly 10,000 supernovae. If everything goes according to plan, ATLAS 3 will see first light before the end of 2021.